Yo.
How is you?
I said hi when you was at G6 in your car, but I don't think you heard. You just been working?
I was, but I had to take a little bit of a break because I had to think about something for quite a bit.
Ooh. I know this is a terrible place to get dropped off, and you can say no, and if you want... Actually, you know what? I'm not even going to do it to you. Can you just drop me to the rental car?
No, tell me we got to be dropped off. I'll drop you off.
Purple dinosaur, though. That's Quay.
It's all the way in Sandy. Go to the house and see if Matt put the car there.
Yeah. All right, as long as you don't mind.
Yeah, I don't really care. That's fine.
All right, then, if you insist... So what's been going on with you? Just chilling?
For the most part, yeah. I've just been trying to make money as best as, you know, as what I do best and talk to people.
Who you been talking to?
Well, Carmela texted me. He's like, can you please find me a man? And then she calls me. I was like, what kind of man are you looking for? She said a rich one. I said, okay, I'm going to be honest, the best bet right now, probably try OTT, or probably that or Jamal. And part of me kind of wanted to throw in Nip Smith in there, just the
Carmella
fuck of it.
And Nip Smith would not be a good idea.
What do you mean?
Oh, God. Deary
me.
I
think you would actually appreciate a queen like herself.
True. He would definitely appreciate her. I don't know if she would appreciate him.
Yeah, that is true.
Oh, how could a woman not appreciate Nip Smith?
He's built like a pack of matches.
I was going to say more like a strawberry lace, but I guess like a matches works.
True, strawberry lace.
I've really helped Matt park the car, bro. I need that for the race later. I'm actually going to be fuming if he hasn't.
Track it, see where it is.
Chris Jays.
Good point.
Need to good go put my bloody contact point. Lens in. Is it this way?
Yeah, take this exit and then take a right. I'm gonna, at some point in the next like 20 minutes, I'm gonna be going to sleep for like an hour and a bit, and then I'm gonna probably be back around if the train conductor likes me.
Alright.
You'll be around a while today?
Yeah, I'm gonna put my contact lenses in probably when I drop you guys off.
Just here is cool. I'm not gonna lie though. I think I might need to meet him on a one-on-one thing, James. I can ask him though. I can ask him.
No, I assume so.
No, but let me ask him because...
Sparky!
Is James cool to be there or driver just me and you?
I mean, James can come.
Alright, okay. It'll just be us two.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. How long it be? I'm about around the corner.
Literally under the nutsack of the purple dinosaur right now.
What the fuck? I'm out 30 seconds out, yeah?
Alright, see you in a sec.
Alright, see you, brother. Bye-bye.
Thank you, GG. I owe you one.
It's okay, you don't need to owe me. But just call me if you ever need anything, alright?
Yeah, I'll call you in a little bit. We'll hang out and do some stuff, yeah?
Alright. Take care.
Come, James. Yeah, you got the call up.
Oh, shit, I just wanted to talk to you. Oh, bye, GG. You said you two, so I thought you meant you and him, so I called him Dusty. Shit.
You plunker. Remember when we was going to try and get a meth lab here?
Yeah. That's going to be like a whole mechanic.
Just going to think for literally a minute. No, I'm not, he's here. Yoo-hoo!
Hey, Zaddy.
Wait, James, why are you texting me saying, sorry, misunderstanding?
Because I called you a Dusty you, innit? Because he said, right, it'll just be the two of us. So I thought that meant you said I couldn't come. So then I called you a
just
Dusty you.
Just the two of us.
We can make it if we try.
Just the
three of us.
Talk to me, Pigeon.
What's going on? What's going on, man? What's going on?
What's crack-a-lacking?
Oh, God.
We need the tea, because I've heard the tea from a very upset Dexter. But I haven't heard the tea from my brother Pigeon.
You heard a false narrative, emotional bitch.
You wanna just version. Before we start, I just wanna say one thing, because I had to let you know this, because I'm gonna keep it real with you, because you are my boy from day. He said he is no longer Pigeon. That boy just capped Taran over.
Yeah, emotional little fucking emotional little freak. Is what he is. Just for that comment, I'm gonna release my diss track on him. Fuck it.
Oh shit.
Ooh. I inspired you, huh?
That guy is an actual freak. I don't know what I don't know how someone can be an ex-Southside ruthless guy, but then, oh, wait a minute. Shit, I forgot. They used to call him FNX Dex. My bad. Maybe not ruthless. Ruthless. Anyway. Anyway. Okay, so... Here we go. Obviously, you know, Dex. I brought Dex along to make weed a bigger thing, right? I approached him, gave him the whole spiel about it, and he fucked with it. He agreed, right? Brought him to the house, invited him over, so he can use it for distributing on behalf of the Colombians, right? Nothing more, nothing less. You know, things were good. Obviously, he was supplying you, whatever. Then there were these 3-4 days where. You know, he acted very bookie. Now, let me make this very clear. Since we're from the UK, let's talk football terms, right? Dex is playing for a football team, wearing the football shirt of the fucking team, for example, Arsenal, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's meant to be a team player. So, what he started doing for about a couple of days was acting very bookie, very not transparent, saying, like, hiding things, right? Saying, oh... NDA this, NDA that. Oh, yeah, but this, that. Oh, I'll let you know when it happens, this, that. That's fine if you're not playing on the fucking same team. Right? Dex isn't someone that was loaning the house. He's not someone that was renting the house. He was someone that was in the operation. Okay? And he was acting very bookie. And then, again, just want to make it very clear, that wasn't the problem why he got kicked, by the way. On the day of him getting kicked, I found out he was part of the company, which is completely fine. If he went and just sat me down and said, yo, Pigeon, I got approached by the company a couple of days ago. I have to grow for them to do some research. Is it cool if I do that to, you know, use your house and shit? That would have been it. That would have been fine. Yeah, say less. As long as you got briefs for distro, cool. The problem is he was on the team acting like someone who wasn't on the team, acting very bookie. Right, telling people who are part of the growing team, don't touch the weed, don't do this, whatever. I don't even give a fuck about that. What made him get kicked was this dumb fuck, stupid, idiotic comment. You ready for this one?
Hmm.
He said, and I quote, if we're being real, Pigeon, we're not even growing for no cartel. So I told him, come to the house, pack up your shit, and just fuck off. You clearly don't understand what we're cooking. You clearly don't understand what we're trying to build. You clearly are short-sighted. You want to sell bricks in MRPD lobbies to Eugene. By all means, that's fine. Go ahead and do that. I don't give a fuck. But you obviously don't see the vision, so come here and you know, just collect your shit, bro, and just go. No bad blood. Because at that moment in time, for me, it wasn't that deep. It's just someone that didn't understand what we're cooking, and that's fine, right? He didn't pay a dollar to the house, so I don't know why he cried like an emotional little freak. But anyway, I thought to myself, it's not that deep. You know, he clearly doesn't understand what we're cooking. And that was it. He came to the house, and it was like I met my ex-wife. Didn't say one word to me. He came to the house, took the weed racks, and then he started bending down. I'm thinking, what, is he going to give me a rose? He's going to like say, I'm sorry. Sorry he has to turn like this. He gets out his fucking hammer. He gets out his fucking saw and starts knocking all the walls down and takes his walls.
Took the toilet as well, right?
He took the toilet. He took the toilet, right? So I'm like, bro, what is going on? I thought to my, like, this is deep. Like, this really ain't that deep. It's someone who clearly disrespected what people believe in, because that comment is like me not believing my mother when I was 5 saying the tooth fairy is coming. What kind of dumb fuck comment was that? Anyway, You know, for me, I should have been more mad, but I wasn't. You know, I let it be, you know, it is what it is. Like, no bad blood, right? I even started lap dancing for him. I'm like, bro, speak to me, bro. What's going on? Why are you acting like a little bitch?
Oh, that's fine, dude.
But, yeah, he got out. And I thought that was it. Fine, you know, that's it. You know, he's going to go for the company. Let him do his thing. That's all cool. I don't give a fuck. Then the next day. My man went from MTV crib showing you and James the fucking secret fucking alleyways in the house to doing a world tour podcast show, going around the whole city, going to you, going to my old family, going to everyone, saying complete fucking waffle, spreading a false narrative, saying some dumb shit about Pigeon fucked up. Pigeon not the same guy from 5 years ago. I didn't know what he's doing. He doesn't know what he's doing.
I'm like, that what it sounds like?
I'm like, bro, why are you so upset? Why are you so upset? Like, I generally do not understand why this motherfucker was so upset. And to go around being an ex-gang leader turned attention seeker, going around spreading false information like a little fucking bitch. What is going on? I don't get it. You know, if you're gonna go around the city and talking shit, at least have some, you know, factual kind of backing, right? He was spreading complete waffle, and that's it, and that's literally it. That's literally what happened.
Yeah, it sounds like it's like what he said, just without a fluff in it, and obviously that statement.
Yeah, no,
when he said about the whole cartel thing, I get you where you're coming from, because you're saying that just completely shuts that. He's shutting down everything you're doing, isn't it? So yeah, I get you.
The thing about me, Sparky, I wasn't even gonna kick him out for not telling me what he's actually doing with the, you know, under the roof that he's not paid a dime for, right? Because I'm a realbie, bro. I mean, James can probably vouch for me since he was close to me back in the day. I let people walk over me, bro. Like, I let people just whatever, bro. It is what it is, right? At the end of the day, you know, I let people eat before I sit on the table. But when you're gonna disrespect shit that not just me, but people that have chipped in that house 100 G's each believe in, get the fuck out of here, bro. Don't come to me with some dumb fuck energy. Get the fuck out. And I wasn't even mad at that time. I would just say, bro, come here, get your shit, enjoy your life. It is what it is, right? But then the next day, my man went to the whole city, like, talking mad weird shit, bro. I don't get it. I really don't. Like, I don't understand. To me, it wasn't that deep. To me, it honestly wasn't that deep. His thinking is race to the top, this, that, and that's completely fine. That's completely fine. But that's not what I'm doing. By all means, good luck to you, brother. Have a good day. But then he blew out the whole thing out of proportion, and I had to waste my fucking day on Saturday going through 8 hours of conversation with people. And the beauty of it all, you want to know two funny things? Everybody that he talked to understood he was just fucking being emotional, and you know, what he said was just pure waffle, because people actually know me, right? And the funniest thing of it all, the company that he was growing for didn't even want him.
Well, he's not growing for them no more. You know that, right?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, exactly.
He's solo again and just selling to anyone and everyone.
Karma is a bitch. Karma is a fucking bitch.
I mean, bro, look, ultimately, the thing is, you always knew where I stand. I've known you way longer than I know Dex. Dex was a man that could get me weed if I needed weed, and he was quick with it.
Yeah.
So that's, you know, there's business and then there's long-term friendship. I fucked with you for the longest. I just need
to. Business.
I just
there's
need
business,
to still be getting my business rolling. So as long as we still got shit, nothing's changed, doesn't it?
Yeah. There's business, there's friendship, and there's not dissing things that you shouldn't be dissing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, again, he spun this whole narrative of like, oh, Pigeon kicked me out of the house because I was withholding so much information from him, but I wasn't. Oh, this, that, bro. It's not that you got kicked. Because you're a dumb fuck and you said some dumb shit and that's it. And I said, bro, just come to the house and take your shit and that's it. And then he the whole day, bro, he went around just talking mad shit and I just don't understand. I really don't get it.
So where does that leave you now in terms of supply? Because obviously
nothing. Supply is, bro.
So you still got good ass weed coming out of ears, yeah?
100%. The problem though, the last couple of days, people haven't been able to drive their weed. Things have changed.
Yeah, that's what I heard as well. The saint said it was just It wasn't meant
to
be like that.
I have 36 bricks waiting for it to be dry.
Advanced seeds? Like, good shit?
Yeah, yeah, top quality shit, bro.
Okay.
Bro, this Dex guy thinks he's the weed kingpin. Please tell me who ran the weed game 5 years ago. You know what I mean? I don't know what this guy is waffling on about.
You know what I mean?
So,
question.
Yeah.
Borderline suggestion. You heard the name Dow Jones?
Don't mention me because I'm a trash. Huh? Weapon?
You heard of this guy called Dow Jones?
Yeah, yeah. Used to be BSK back in the day. I think.
Man's moving mad weight, bro. And apparently he knows a lot. He's active. Maybe it's worth you having a combo with him because that the
last person. Well. No. Everybody in this operation's handpicked because they're like-minded. They understand, you know, things, right?
Mm.
You told me to pick Dex, and look what happened.
I didn't tell you to pick Dex.
Yes, you did.
You was working with Dex before I knew you was working.
No.
You're chatting grease.
Brother, you're like, yeah, Dex is a big weed guy. You should go to him. And I agreed because he is.
Oh, no, yeah, I did do that.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, but I mean, was I wrong, though?
Well, I mean, you're not.
Because like, on a baseline business level, he put in a call to me today saying, yo, do you need bricks? I didn't get that call from you. And that's not on a friendship thing. That's on a he's got the supply. Where there's the demand.
Listen here, you dumb bitch.
Don't call me a dumb bitch.
Listen to me.
Because I've got a fucking toilet and you don't. So don't call me a dumb bitch.
Actually, we don't have a toilet.
Well, yeah. My apartment's decked out. Actually, I pulled that one out as well. Okay, maybe I don't have a toilet either, but I ain't a bitch, all right? That's besides the fucking point.
Why don't we piss and shit in each other's mouths? I'll take turns. You know, you go first, I go first.
What?
We got to do something.
Why don't you do it in Dex's mouth?
So anyway, that is the story. I don't know what other story he spun. I don't know why he's being weird and saying things like, depending on the thing, 5 years, the guy.
Honest, I don't even care about the story. That's not my business. I just care about getting weed and keeping it moving. And the reason why I hadn't even called you is because I thought this had hindered what we had going on. But if it hasn't hindered what we going on, then
no, it definitely hasn't.
Is what it is.
Definitely hasn't.
Keep it moving.
Definitely hasn't. If anything, it's gone better. At least I don't have a.
Well, the whole fucking city is currently feral for weed.
Yeah, exactly. But here's now here's my issue now. For this is where you are gonna be in a problem too. For the operation. Yeah, for the next 2 weeks, every Tom, Dick, and Harry wants weed, yeah? Wants bricks, whatever. But they're trying to reach that point where they can name their strain, right? On their little app on the phone. Once they do that, they can no longer push random bricks. That's the issue.
When you say they cannot push random bricks. They can't or they won't because it's not financially worth it.
They can't. They cannot purchase a turf and push.
So Benny won't
weed.
Speak to you once you're on turf.
No. You can push bricks off on weed runs. I'm talking about. Ultimately, Benny doesn't want you doing weed runs. He wants you pushing on the streets.
Yeah, with turf.
Right. Yeah. So what I'm trying to say, let's say your gang is called fucking Bob. When your gang Bob purchases turf and you name a strain fucking Skittles, you can only push Skittles in your turf. Right? That is the problem I'm now having for distribution. It really kills the middleman and distribution game quite a lot. It kills what you're planning to do with a block that, you know, we wanted to do. The only way it will work is this. Having the growers on the gangs of apps that we supply. For example, let's say the company approaches the cartel or whatever. For them to get weed from us or from you, the growers would need to be on their app. Yeah, it's shitty and it kind of defeats very ominous kind of anonymous kind of feeling of it all, but that is the only way distribution of weed could actually work.
I still think there's a market for the runs though.
Because you've got to think
about it like this, right?
No, there is. It might not be as big as right now.
There's a big insurgence right now. But ultimately, if you want to buy a chip for your tablet, you need max rep. If you want to be the guy that can buy a turf, you need max rep. I think you'll get a lot of people trying to do it.
No, exactly. Weed distribution will never be killed. It's just that the kind of building the whole, I don't know how to put some words, when, you know, when we used to distro to gangs, it was more than just a customer, right? It was a whole thing built around it. That's going to be harder to do now because they can't just get random bricks. It has to be their strain. And the only way to do that is by having them invite username XX Trickshot 420 Phase XX to their gang app. Which isn't that bad, but again, it kind of kills that, you know, that feeling of, you get what I'm trying to say?
I hear that for the future, but right now we need to be selling weight.
Yeah, no, yeah, right now my issue is fucking drying. I'm sitting on 36 bricks waiting for drying. I'm just sitting on it. I don't know what's going on.
Well, currently on the intel, like, I got Dex is pumping weed out to every Tom, Dick and Harry as we speak.
You sure about that?
Yes.
Have you guys got dried weed or no?
Nah,
we have three racks.
We got wet
full
weed.
Of weed.
Yeah.
And no, but how long has it been on that rack?
2-3 days.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. In the next 12 hours, if things hasn't dried in the racks, there's something, I don't know what's going on. Something's happening. But supply isn't the problem.
How many have you got reserved so far? You got none?
15.
Let me grab 15 of those as well.
Yeah, 100%. So my issue right now is not fucking having the best weed because we already have that. It's not having the kind of supply. It's literally the drying process. We have 12 racks, two medium racks included, just waiting with dangling fucking wet weed. So I don't know what the hell's going on. By the way, is it true that a high quality weed, Benny gives you more kisses for it?
Yeah.
Like, not money. I mean, more like, you know.
Way more, bro. Motherfuckers will. Okay. There's been a bunch of people that I've run into that will literally throw shit quality weed into a fucking lake and won't do runs unless they get the high grade. You got to remember, right? In this city, everyone wants to get as much done with the least effort and the little amount of time. That's how people work, right? So, like,
yeah.
However good the strain is, the more rep they're going to get, the more they're willing to do it. Like, ain't even about, that's why right now it's golden, because it's not even about the money. No one gives a shit about the money they're making from it. They just want the rep. So, like, you can, 600 flat is doable as fuck right now. Think about a week ago, we were selling for fucking 500.
I sold a brick last storm for 800.
Yeah, that's what, bro, so yeah, fiends. Yeah, fiends, bro.
Yeah, the issue right now, the issue is the drying. I'm hoping in the next 12 hours, things are going to be fully, like, hella dry. I want
to
have a
issue is though, you're not going to be the only one waiting for shit to dry.
Yeah, exactly.
So you are going to have, like, once your shit dries, the market's going to get flooded with everyone else who's been waiting on to dry as well.
I want to get to a stage where I'm doing 30 bricks dried every 3 days, but that is mathematically impossible unless I got like fucking 40 racks. That's literally mathematically impossible. So, yeah.
Well, there's got to be, you know, there's no reason why Eddie might not plug a fucking some bigger racks eventually. So if you currently in your operation, you've got a max grower, that's caught, right? You got one of those.
Yeah, I have. Yeah, we have. Yeah, we have
you,
max
but
grower.
You don't have a max shotter.
No, because we don't need that.
Yeah, no, I know you don't, but I'm just like, yeah, for my own man, because I'm going to be that. Well, probably end of tonight.
Yeah, so I had a talk with a few of the weed people. There isn't a point for what I'm trying to do to be on the, like, for us to make our own HQ app. It just doesn't make sense because we're not going to be pushing our own weed because we're distributing to other people, not pushing our own weed. You know what I mean?
You want me to be honest about that?
Yeah.
I think you're shooting yourself in the foot if you don't do that.
But that defeats the, what, like, why would I?
Currently, with the information you've got right now, 100% currently it does. But the last thing you want to happen is you don't pursue naming a strain, and then all of a sudden, after a while, when you hit a certain rep level with that strain, it becomes sellable everywhere.
Yeah, and that's the issue I'm having is I need to join a gang, and I'm going to be joining a gang today.
Who?
I'm joining the Wastelanders. To make it in the city, I've had good talks with I just had a good talk with Tommy T about 2 weeks ago. I had a good talk to a lot of people. You cannot be on your own in this economy. It is impossible. If you want to quote unquote progress,
all you gotta do is shake the hand, Pigeon.
My God, it'd be like old times.
I've been told you that. I'm gonna put a hand back in the pocket. Just know the handshake stays pending.
What kind of signing bonus are we talking about?
Oh, fuck yourself.
We can go on another date on Danger I'll pay if you want.
I'll fucking throw you off the fucking fun fair, you little prick.
Fuck?
But the group that will inevitably be forming in the next coming days most likely is going to be very driven, smaller, and good for getting shit done. We're already working on having one person specialized in everything. James is pushing money washing.
So that's what I said to people as well. If I made this operation into a crew or gang, it will be the most efficient operation, because I have everybody in every field, but it's not a gang. So maybe either I gotta, you know, make it a gang, which I'm not going to
do. But why does it need to be a gang?
Make any sense it's
what you make it. The only one that can give it a label is you. Like, just because you're on the HQ app doesn't mean you necessarily have to be a gang. You might get seen as that, but...
Plus, you can also be in multiple HQ apps.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah. Oh, you didn't know that?
No.
Well, how do you... How else would you thought that the growers would be on people's apps, you idiot?
You never said the growers are on apps.
That's what...
No, we did, to be fair.
I said the only way distribution would work in the future, you clown... is have the growers of the operation be
on
people's
app. Right,
apps.
Got you. Yeah, that makes sense.
But yeah, for that, yeah. So
that's what I'm saying. Like, we are working on a max rep grower.
Yeah, the tablet
is going to be there tomorrow. By the way,
the tablet is literally like a phone.
Yeah, I know.
So having two phones, having two tablets with two different chips, that's two different HQ accounts.
Right, got you.
So that's how you can join different thingies. Yeah. So that's what's happening. Weed is just being ready to drive. 36 bricks. Hopefully it all comes in one big shot. We can do one massive fucking thingy. But yeah. That's what's happening. What's the name of your crew? Or are you still TBC?
I ain't done all that yet.
I got a name for you.
Go on.
You ready?
Go on.
Yeah.
Waiting.
Wasteman.
Wow. Which intrusive thought gave you that one?
Yeah. Oh, fuck yourself.
No, I thought of it myself. I thought of Wasteland and I was like, oh, I might as well just, you know, intertwine the two. You know what I mean?
Oh, guess who's calling me right now?
Emotional freak?
I mean, I got him saved his decks, but... So, are you working with Patar?
Guess who's calling me now?
Matt's mom?
Patar?
Your fucking mother. Hello?
Sorry, it was Matt's mom.
He's Eddie!
Hey, what's going on? How you doing? Yeah. I made a few calls. Things might happen. I'm waiting on something. Yeah, I got you. Yeah.
Doing codeine with my.
100%. Give me 20 minutes. Yeah. I love you. Bye bye. Lafardi, Lagardi, Ferrari. Fuck! All my families are disbanding. It's not good.
Yeah, Italians. Rip.
Yeah.
Yeah, so what's your situation then? Like, you've just got a bunch of individuals combined under one roof.
So the thing that I've been cooking for the last fucking month is to do with strictly the distribution, right? And is the whole weed side is completely just held by an app, which is kind of fucked, but it is what it is. You need to adapt, I guess. But the thing that I'm trying to build is I'm trying to create mini fucking pigeons, basically. So rather than me doing the whole shebang, I've got people like you creating your own clientele giving you that opportunity of creating your own fucking clientele, your own thing, back the whole fucking force. You know what I mean? That's what I'm trying to do. But sadly, you know, it's hard to do that because not many people have that work ethic. And people are fucking lazy, like this guy to my left of me. But that's what I'm trying to do.
At that point, yeah, you may as well just whack six mirrors in a room and just stand there. Bro said, I'm looking for a gang of pigeons.
That's...
You called them crows.
Oh, that's the mad. Flock. Oh my gosh, I made my own crew called the flock. Buzz with a feather flock together. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you do that. You do that.
Okay, but anyway, yeah. So I'm trying to do what I did 5 years ago, but on a bigger scale involving... My main goal was to get a room of people together that you would never think would ever be in a room together. You know what I mean? Have
what you got in the room of a girl?
Why did I bring this guy to the conversation, Sparky? Why is this guy even here? Is the question?
Go on, stand your ground, James. Stand on business.
I'm still here.
Two of us, one of you, mate.
That's the beauty of it. You know what I mean?
Smile through it, yeah. Bro did the typical, yo, you got the time, bro. Just smiled through it. It was like, nice to see you guys. Hope you're having a great evening.
So, yeah, that's what I'm trying to do. And that's what's happening. There's a lot of people that you would never, ever thought would ever be talking to one another. And that's the kind of beauty of it all, you know what I mean? So, yeah. But no, it isn't gang-related, any crew-related shit. And that's where I'm at a stage here, Sparky, where...
It's almost like you should just literally make a Colombian's app and everyone on there has a Colombian alias and then it's just fucking all under one roof, but it's not a gang, it's a cartel, because cartel and gang is basically the same thing. One's just Mexican and one isn't.
Colombians are not... Are you fucking stupid?
I said what
you
I said.
The egg.
Are you fucking dumb? Did you... Wait, unless I'm dumb or are you dumb?
Yeah, it's a Colombian and Mexican, two different things, I know. I'm pretty sure anyway. Cartel is more Mexican than it is Colombian, but I might be wrong.
No, what I'm trying to say to you, absolute
no,
egghead,
no, no. What that... I'm trying to say to you, yeah, is you're scrambling
what I'm
around
trying to say to you...
looking for the answer. No. Hear me out.
You listen to me.
But it's answer, you're going, oh, I don't want to be bound by a gang app. The only one calling it a gang app is you, bucko. You just need to continue with your ideas. Stop overthinking all this
listen,
shit.
Listen, you egg.
Get the
can
people
speak,
in your
speak?
Operation grouped up, yeah? So that you can
speak?
Fucking put them on there and get
anywhere.
Your operation moving,
let
bruv. You
me
said,
speak, you absolute
walk,
muppet.
Run.
Don't
and right now,
don't
yeah, right now, you're at a coffee shop, sipping
can
a coffee, bro.
Oh, here we go. Can I speak?
Shop.
Can I speak?
If I not go yet, to not the yet, wait. Go ahead.
If I go to the whole process, can you shut up, James, you dumb prick?
Sorry.
Like I was saying, right? If I go through the whole process of that HQ bullshit app, right? Whatever the hell you're trying to say. You let me know, from your point of view, what is the point of that in my shoes? Why would a distro be so doing their own runs? Doesn't make any sense.
You're looking at it as exactly what is in front of you right now. Because for one, the HQ app has a robbery section, right? It's not just bound to this one thing.
I think HQ app is very weed oriented.
Yeah, no, so do I. I agree. But
so
the premise you're going on is why would I commit to that because it offers these things? But what if you wake up Wednesday morning and it offers you a way to do something that is extremely beneficial to your operation?
And that's why me joining a actual thing makes sense, not me turning the Colombians into a fucking you know what I mean?
Well, you need to make sure that you've got your people in a position so that you're not gonna be fucked over if an opportunity arises. Because that's where I am right now, right? I could have got max rep with weed ages ago. We want to go down the gang route. If I was max rep 3 weeks ago, then we would have been on the turf selling already. So I made that mistake of not getting there. You do the same thing. You might be in the same situation where you're like, fuck, I should have done this then so that I'm not lagging.
Yeah, no, I completely get what you're saying. But that's that just goes against the whole idea of what I'm trying to build.
You just
right?
need to drop the whole gang thing. Like, it's whatever you want it to be, bro. It don't need to be like. I think you got PTSD of the old way of living, of like the gang app, you know? Like,
oh, I do have PTSD.
Yeah, I know you do. Much to all of us. You just got to get that out of your head and see it as something new.
That's why That is why. Forget this whole thing, that this whole distribution shift for now, right? That is why I said to Tommy T and said to fucking Baton, said to all these bloody bastards that, you know, it is good and it is needed to be in a backed crew, gang or family, whatever the fuck you want to call it. That is the way forward. Making the whole operation doesn't make sense. Because it goes against the whole idea of what it is.
I get that, but you don't know what the way forward is right now.
It's like a football player
no one
trying
does.
To play basketball. You know what I mean?
But you don't know, because you like the game ain't even started yet, bruv.
It could even be like, ice hockey.
If that's the analogy you're on, you ain't even left the dressing room yet. Bruv.
All right, Gaff, you aren't, mate. You're going for a show, Governor. You aren't, mate.
You don't know, bro. You don't know what's gonna happen. There might pop up a little section on the HQ app calling, press this button to start a cartel. You don't know, bro. You don't know the results. So you can't speak with definiteness right now. No one can.
You're not wrong, but I did kind of say everything that was going to happen has happened, and it has happened. So... There's a thing of being a realist, and there's a thing of just false hope.
Yeah, but
I mean?
Then there's also being Delulu.
And that's Dex, not me.
I'm not saying you're Delulu, but you don't want to be naive because you think you know it when it hasn't happened yet. You know?
Not wrong. I just don't. I mean, it can happen. I just don't feel like wasting the time and energy on doing all of that stuff. And it's wasting other people's time as well. I don't know. I mean. Yeah, cool. Okay, hear me out, right? Hear me out. Cool. HQ map. Get the growers on there. Get just random sellers on there. First of all, I don't know how that's even going to... Who the fuck's going to sell? But anyway, get random sellers on there. You know, I just don't see the point as being a distributor. It just doesn't make any sense.
Well, then let me pitch you an idea.
Go on.
You can overlap turfs, right? What's to stop you claiming a turf that has already got other people on it, but the people on that turf distribute your shit? So you're claiming a turf and you're not pushing it yourself, but all the people that you are working with are distributing in the turf that you've got claimed, and you provide them the weed.
Batar's already working on the app for you guys anyway. He's got a mining rack and everything set up, so.
Well, no, we're working on getting more, like, just Bitcoin in general, right? I talked to him about the app. I told him, like, there's not really a point, because unless we are just going to supply ourselves. And that just, I don't really, you know, that's not really the kind of goal we're going for with this whole thing. It would just go against it, you know what I mean? But, here, let me pitch you an idea, ready? I drop this whole fucking operation when it comes to the weed shit and join you in 20 years.
I'm gonna be real with you, I'm dead in 20.
How old are you?
He's like 60.
Fuck off.
I'm not 60.
You want to say Patan's calling? Give me a second.
45.
Yo, what's up, Patan? I'm missing a meeting with
Spark. Have a drink.
Everything good?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got you, brother.
All right, boy. We cool here anyway. But think on it, innit? You know what I mean? It's one of them. But
yeah.
Also, 15 bricks. Whenever you can get them, I'll take them off your hands.
I got you. Hopefully, shit.
Bro, you fucking noshing off that drink.
Hopefully, shit is dry by tomorrow and they can get things sorted out, you know what I mean?
Yup. Beautiful.
Goodbye, James. Goodbye, Sparky.
Good talking.
Bye, Zaddy. Wait, we need a lift. Pigeon, can we get a lift back, please, mate?
I'm going sleep. Sure, I've got to have brain surgery.
What?
I'll be back around most likely in 2 hours if the conductor lets me.
bloody hell.
Alright.
So much for weed.
What? The reason I'm getting a surgery in the first place, you bastard, is so that I can do a weed run without a fucking head pop.
What's he waffling on about?
You should have got max rep first.
Well, you're going to sleep.
You better be careful.
Yeah, you're going to sleep.
No, I'm not going to sleep. Sleep. I'm getting brain surgery and waking back up.
What are you getting surgery part of this?
I'm just getting my cranium optimized. You get me?
I don't know what that means. Go fuck yourself.
Go fuck yourself. Yo, gang-op phobia, bitch-ass motherfucker.
Fuck you, prick.